five edgewood countertop starts by taking a tree and slicing it the long way into a series of thin slices straight down the tree. Now, every tree has a lifespan. This doesn't waste wood. This conserves wood in managed forests. But ultimately, a tree lives between 40 and 100 years. And so when it comes to the top of its lifespan, it's time to reap the harvest of that tree and make the most of what nature gives us. So we take that tree and we number our slices on through. And when we take those sequence slices, we unfold them like a book, they will match. So this is a pair of slices through a tree. This is a Claro walnut. It's from California, always prized for its figure, which is that grain pattern. I'm going to put something on there to kind of show off what this tree will give us when there's a finish on it. Okay. See those nice wild grains? They're going to be a nice mirror image. And what we're going to do is study that tree and how we can remove enough to join the slabs. And what we're going to leave at the end is the natural sapwood edge. It's usually white. There's no color. The nutrients of a tree flow in the outside 2 inches of the tree, so it's called sapwood. When we conserve that, we're going to take the bark off the tree. We're going to polish this nice white wood out here. That will define the natural shape of our tabletop. We're going to cut away some. We may fill some of this with resin or metal or turquoise to bring out the best. Ultimately, we're going to create a straight line and mark it where we're going to join our tree. We're going to straight line that, glue it back together. We may introduce some butterflies. A very traditional way of giving a wood joint strength or signifying as a zebra one. We have dark butterflies too. This is African wenge. So the artist has choices. And using these traditional methods, we're going to show you some tabletops and what these techniques will offer.